Last night, we told you about Honolulu police officer misconduct. Today, we're learning how HPD determines its penalties. According to the Honolulu Police Department's 2014 report submitted to the legislature, 39 officers were punished last year for misconduct. The list varies from assault, insurance fraud, illegal cockfighting, gambling operations, even one officer caught surfing on the job. So, how does the department determine how to punish its officers, and are there any inconsistencies in those punishments? Nestor Garcia dug deeper to find out. Ness?
Joe, we took a closer look at the report and found that the department's administrative actions do not appear to be consistent as we compared the one case involving that surfing incident against other cases that one senator told me were much more serious. The report only focuses on administrative actions taken against those officers suspended or discharged for violating the department's standards of conduct. Here is one case where the report cites an officer who punched his son in the chest with a closed fist, then punched and kicked holes in the wall next to his son's head. The administrative action in this case, a 10-day suspension. In another case, an officer was caught surfing on the job and was also caught with the surfboard on a city-owned and police-subsidized vehicle. The penalty, a 1-day suspension. That surfing incident caught the eye of Senator Laura Thielen, which reminded her of HPD's investigation of alleged criminal cases of domestic violence involving two officers 2 years ago.
But the administrative penalty was a 1-day suspension. What you see in this report here is the administrative penalty against an officer for surfing while on duty was a 1-day suspension.
I approached the police department to ask how HPD determines the penalty for each and every case, but could not get anyone to speak on camera. What I was told was the general procedure for how the department goes about investigating misconduct. There's first an investigation, and the findings are then sent to an administrative review board, which is made up of the deputy and assistant chiefs. That board then forwards the recommendation to the chief, who can either accept the recommendation or determine for himself what, if any, discipline is imposed on the officer.
Were you able to find out what the outcome of those criminal cases involving those police officers?
No, we can't find the outcome of the criminal cases because under the special exemption the police currently have under the law, the names are not released.
It's that special exemption for police that some lawmakers are pushing to eliminate this year.
When it comes to tax dollars and who's working for the public, and especially individuals who are carrying guns and who might be making life and death situations, we need to know who the bad apples are versus those that are not.
Now, Senator Thielen has introduced a bill that would do away with that special exemption for officers that prohibits the release of their names when it comes to misconduct cases. I will be following that legislation and report on its progress. Nestor Garcia, KHON 2 News.
The three other counties are also mandated to release their police misconduct cases. Last year on the Big Island, 16 officers were disciplined in 33 cases of misconduct. That's because some of the officers had multiple violations. The most severe was the case of an officer disciplined for inappropriate physical contact with a minor. That officer was dismissed from the force. We made repeated requests with the police departments on Kauai and Maui for their reports, but we have yet to receive them.